It's time for the Giz Wiz with Mads Mattis writer Dick DeBartolo. This is episode 1613, recorded Wednesday, March 8th, 2017. Just add toilet water. On this episode of the Giz Wiz, we have the last three gadgets from Toy Fair. Some things to play with while you're on the toilet, some pianos, and a way to get wet. All coming up next on The Giz Wiz!
It's the same show with Dickie D and OMG chat on your PC. It's time for The Giz Wiz because gadgets are his business. They've got a gizmo sickness, geek disease,
under pathology,
rows and rows of USBs, growing blue LEDs. Get ready for The Giz Wiz now.
Now! It is time for the Giz Wiz, and here he is, the ambassador for gadgets, Dick DeBartolo. How are you doing, Dickie D?
I'm doing fine, and you, sir?
Doing good myself. It's been a good week. My parents are coming into town next week.
Oh, so, is that why you're leaving town?
Well, no. But they are coming in. Well, everything's been coming on at once. Like, it seems like for 3 or 4 weeks, everything was simple. Nothing was changing. Now this weekend, I'm headed off to PAX South. We're recording a day early. Then next weekend, my parents are coming into town. And then the weekend after that, I may be flying out to Florida. And then it's just like, oh my gosh, it all happens at once, doesn't it?
Oh, yes, it does.
Spring. It does. Spring has sprung. How about you? How have you been?
I have been good. Nothing thrilling at this end here. The weather here is just nutty. We had 60 degrees and we're going to have snow over the weekend. And it's just very, very bizarre.
Yeah.
Yeah. And I'm watching a game show I may be doing for Mad. Have you ever seen a game show called The Wall?
Is that maybe I can I'll take a guess and you tell me if I'm wrong or right. I believe it's where they have cutouts in a wall, and they move the wall down a thing, and you have to fit into it. Is that right?
Oh no! That wasn't a different show. No, the wall is like a four-story high wall where they drop balls that fall like in a pinball
Plinko
machine
or something.
Yeah. Yes, it is. It's exactly like Plinko, except at the bottom there are like slots for $1 million.
$2 million.
It's actually quite exciting. And then also, there's a point at which if you get things wrong, they drop a red ball. You have to drop red balls, and the red balls now deduct those amounts that they fall into. There you go. It's really quite interesting. I mean, it's very intricate.
Wow. And,
yeah.
So you're going to be on it, hosting it? What are you?
No. I'm probably going to write the satire of it.
Oh, that's great! Oh, that's fun.
So yeah, it will be fun.
Be fun. That's actually fantastic. That's really, really cool. That's Chris Hardwick is the host, isn't it?
Yes, it is.
Yes, it is. I went to go see Chris Hardwick has sort of a late night show on, or he did. I haven't really kept up with it. But I saw that was one of the only tapings that I went to when I was in L.A. I went to Chris Hardwick's taping of, I forget.
I know. The late show and late night and p.m. night. And
yeah, exactly. It was
the night before,
show with comedians and it was late night and I don't remember. It was for Comedy Central.
Oh, okay.
So, yeah, that's very cool. That is neat. That is very neat. Very neat.
And you're off to PAX in the morning, right?
I'm off to PAX in the morning. Yeah, no joke. So PAX East in Boston, I'll be heading out there for the weekend. This is the first time that I've gone anywhere with a dog, you know, with Charlie. And so I spent the last few days looking at doggy boarding places, trying to find the best one near me that had the best reviews, and I finally found a place, luckily. So, but gosh, it's a whole new experience.
Yes. Oh, okay. I thought you said you were taking him with you. I was going to say, oh my God.
That would have been crazy. That would have been fun, actually. Yeah. I wish. It would have made things simpler in some ways. I don't know how he would do it on an airplane, but
I would not want to be a doggy in a cargo hole.
I've always had daydreams of training him as a service dog, you know, and then you can take him anywhere. He's a service dog.
Oh, yeah. Okay.
I have no idea what that would take. It's just a daydream. I haven't ever thought about it since that. But how cool would that be? He can come in here. He's a service dog. What's the service? He serves me a few times.
Right, that's right. Well, ask him to get you a drink, and he'll get it for
exactly.
you.
Exactly. Right. He's the best serving dog that's around. That would be cool, but maybe one day. The same day that I get an electric car.
Yes. How many nights are you going to be away without Charlie?
It would be Thursday night, Friday night. Wait, no. Yes. Thursday, Friday, Saturday, and Sunday.
Oh, my gosh.
Yeah.
Oh, my gosh.
Yeah. Yeah. All so, right. Yes. My butler dog, Charlie.
He's did they have drop cams at the place where?
Some did, some didn't. This one promises to send me photos whenever I ask.
Oh. So,
hey, go over and send a selfie of Charlie. So they'll go and do that. It's pretty good. But yeah, there was a few, and a lot of them have nowadays like a deluxe room and like a normal pleb room. But the deluxe room comes with the drop cam. You know, you get to see him all the time. The normal dog room doesn't get that. So for like a fee extra. But yeah, exactly. So heading off to see more video games over the weekend. And we'll be back next week, same time, same Giz Wiz time, same Giz Wiz place.
All right, well, let's jump into this week.
Some gadgets.
Yeah, okay, so we're wrapping up Toy Fair 2017 with three gadgets. We're going to start out with toy pianos that have grown up. So let's watch our video.
Here we go. Jump in.
Hey, Dick DeBartolo, Mads Maddest writer, and the Giz Wiz, one take theater here at gizwiz.tv. We're at Show and Hut. They make pianos. They make pianos for 150 plus years. Now, are all the new Show and Hut pianos available to be used with electronic devices?
So everything that we've released for this year is going to be digital. So we still carry the traditional mechanical Show and Hut pianos, but everything that you see here in the booth, in the back of the booth, is digital, so it can connect to an app, an iPad, tablet, even on your cell phone. Have just the little cell phone right here and be able to follow along. So instead of the kid having to press one finger at a time on the tiny iPad or tablet, they actually learn the proper finger placement. They learn the proper feel for the keys, and they're going to learn how to transition from this toy into a true piano.
That is really great. Can we walk over there? I want to show you or show our audience some of these other pianos that are so neat. We'll start with the little guy here. So what is this retail for?
So this is a brand new prototype. This is actually going to be a baby grand with legs and a bench and everything. The retail on this is going to be right around $150.
Okay, and these are all app adjustable. And Android and iOS.
Yep. Absolutely. And there are a number of different apps. We don't have a Show and Hut app. What we demo here and what we show all of our customers, they're just apps that you can download off of the app stores for free.
Okay, great. That's good news. And this, I forgot the price point on these guys.
So this is $100 at retail. This is a 25-key version of this 61-key. So this is the smallest that we have with the app compatibility.
And that's about 100?
About 100 at retail, yep.
And this guy?
This is a 37-key butterfly, so it's modeled after the old Wurlitzer butterfly piano. And this one retails for about $250. And this is a 37-key version of this big 61-key.
Okay, button. And the big one that you were playing retails for?
This one's about $500, probably between $500 and $600 at retail.
Okay, and these guys?
And this guy is about $250 to about $325.
And then the deluxe?
That's the same as the pink. They're the same. The black, for some reason, everyone does think it's bigger. The black color apparently gives it a little bit more depth.
Yeah, that is really great.
I think the black just looks more like a real piano.
Yeah. Is there a candelabra option?
Yeah. Well, I think if you put your wings down, you could make a nice setup there. Really give it some mood.
That is really great. Kids wanting to learn how to play the piano, this is an incredible way to go. Show and Hud, as we said, how many years? 150?
145 this year. We were founded in 1872.
Wow!
145 years. GizWiz.tv, Dick DeBartolo, Man's Maddest Writer, and the Giz Wiz. Toy Fair 2017. Bye.
The Giz Wiz has almost been going on for that long as well.
Yeah, exactly.
Episode 1600. Right. Wow, that is absolutely amazing. Those pianos look so well crafted. And
yeah, that. Wow. And also, now that they're digital, you know, no more rinky dink sound.
Right.
Because, you know, there'll be digital sounds.
You don't have to worry about tuning them, you know.
Yeah.
That's
and
great.
The pianos can record and play back. And
that's amazing. I would really also love to know a little bit more about the apps. I know there's things like GarageBand that come, you know, with the iPad. I'm assuming that it's compatible with that. That's amazing that an app
with the piano
can talk to an iPad or a phone. That's incredible. That's really incredible.
Yes. And one of the pianos had like an app on that had like dancing animals for the keys.
Oh, wow.
And as someone at Show and Hut said, is that the great thing about it is the kids think they're playing a video game, but in reality, they're learning how to play the piano in a very fun way. And someone else there said they couldn't remember the name of the app, but there's one piano teaching app for kids where you don't have to stay in the room with the kid because the app emails you a summary of how the kid did on playing the piano. So that way you don't have to worry about being in the room.
That's
although
amazing.
With the headphone jacks, you know, you just
yes,
say,
exactly.
Wear
right.
your headphones. Wear your headphones.
Yeah, put those headphones on. Sit closer to the iPad, please. yeah, that's amazing. Yeah, you were. I'm sorry, Jimmy, but says here in this email that you were distracted for 13% of the time during your piano.
Yeah.
No gushers for you. That's awesome. Wow. I wish that. I would have had one of these as a kid. Spend time learning piano instead of watching cartoons. That's fantastic.
Do you play any instrument?
Drums.
Drum? All right. Well, that's
no,
more
I
than
don't.
Me.
You,
oh, you don't even play.
You can smack a drum. Anyone can smack a drum.
Oh yeah, I can hit a drum.
Yeah, you can hit a drum.
I
don't actually play like a drum set. No. I've always wanted to get into music, but it's one of those things that I have always felt is unobtainable because of just the amount of time that you need to
exactly
to
you
put
need,
into it.
Yeah, you need time to.
But yeah, so the toypianoshop.com has all, it looks like all of these little pianos.
Yes, right. Now, not all of those
are probably the
new ones,
right.
or the new digital ones.
Right.
But they have a huge line of pianos. I mean, this company's been around for, 145 years.
And, I'm just amazed, you know, for the same price as a Hot Wheels, you can get a piano, you know? You can have a piano in your house.
You can put wheels on it and make it into a
make
combo.
Make it a Hot Wheel. I'm sure that if you put a rope on it and you had a boat, it could be, you know, a surfboard, too. Just absolutely amazing. So, the Toy Piano Shop, or toypianoshop.com.
And toypiano.com goes to their company website, and toypianoshop.com lists all the different pianos that they make.
And they are
also helping to sponsor the world's first Toy Piano Day.
What?
Toy Piano Day starts March 18th.
Wow. So, that's exciting.
Oh, you know what? That's ridiculous that they didn't update their website. I'm just looking. It says Toy Fair 2016. Hello, Show and Hut.
Exactly. So anyway, this is really amazing. I like this gadget. I think that, I'm going to guilt my parents into not getting me this when I was a kid, you know? I could have learned the piano then, Mom. Come on. No, I'm just kidding.
Yeah.
Awesome. Great.
Okay, moving on to Zing. Zing made a Wethead. So let's see what Zing has for 2017.
Hey, Dickie Bartolo, Mads Maddest Writer, and the Giz Wiz. One Take Theater here at GizWiz.tv. We're at Toy Fair 2017. Remember Wethead? Okay, well, the folks at Wethead have a new game called Blast Box. So I think this is how it works. There are balloons under here and a mallet, and then they told me that I have to get in here, and then I have to kind of
It's a magic trick.
As they drive the mallets in. You know, I'm game for... No, that's not how it plays,
no,
right?
No, we don't want to do that at all to you.
Forget all that. Okay, and first of all, we're going to show you how it works. This is a gigantic reproduction of the original, of the regular game, so we're going to show you both.
Yeah.
Right, we can put that on the floor. Yeah, okay. So tell us how Blast Box works.
Absolutely.
Introduce yourself first.
I'm Christy. I'm from Zing Toys, and we have... three giant balloons inside this box, and then what you do is you drive down these mallets and try and pop the balloons, but you spin the wheel, and that determines how many mallet drives that you go.
Oh, okay, so it's the same as the number of times that you would click the thing.
Exactly, yeah,
okay.
For the wethead.
Okay, can I do it?
Absolutely.
Okay, so, I spin it, sure.
Woo!
You get this at home, it's not going to be this big. All right, so what you do is you have to drive these down. There are balloons in here, and the object is not to break the balloon. And it turns out that I am so good at this. This is my 500th pin. That was my 499. Anyway, okay. And now we're going to go over there, and you'll see how it really
Amazing.
Plays. Okay, let's see how big the game is. We'll go over here. I'm going to get my mic up over this. Ta-da. Okay.
The actual game is right here. That's four times larger than this game here. So the smaller version right here, we have the three balloons inside. Oh, yes, you can see. You normally put three. We have one because it was kind of a game in process here. And then would you like to do the honors?
I only have to hit one down?
Well, there's
okay.
Actually,
I didn't see where the balloons were.
Yeah.
Uh-oh, I don't like... Oh, no! What do you do if it's...
Go, go.
Yeah! All right. I lost my $500. Okay, when is this coming out?
This comes out... Spring. Yes, spring. Spring release,
okay.
Yep.
And it is Blast Box from Zing. Dick DeBartolo, Mads Maddest Writer, and the Giz Wiz One Take Theater here at GizWiz.tv. Bye.
So it's almost like a Jenga feel to it, it seems like, because you have, you know, balloons, and you might push a by a balloon, and then after a while, after you've been playing, you know, the balloon can't move anywhere, so you gotta hit it eventually.
Yes.
Interesting.
I think the thing is, I didn't see the instructions, but I assume that each person puts a balloon in, or you put a balloon in for each person. So I think the people playing should be allowed to see what where the balloons are before you put it down flat.
Right.
So that would give you some strategy.
Yeah, whoa, sorry.
Oh, that's okay. You can run that. It's only 30 seconds.
Okay, here we go.
Careful approach. The tension is palpable. What a turn!
Oh no! Oh, and we have a winner! The exciting game with a bang.
From Zing!
Zing!
Cool.
My guess would be is to probably always start on the edges of the game,
exactly.
Because you'd be less likely to hit a balloon. Turns out that Amazon actually shows it as available.
Right, four left in stock for $20.
For $20, and it comes with. I'm reading off your copy. Blast Box. Go back to the second.
Here we go.
Because 100 balloons, 20 easy balloon clips. 30 knock-in pins and a little hammer. So I think kids have fun with that for $20. And it's called Blast Box. Yeah, Blast Box.
Very fun. Okay, Blast Box from Zing.
Blast Box, Zing.
Another fun project.
Now, our last guy is another Get Wet game. And I have to be honest here. I did not see this in person. It's from Hasbro. And Hasbro has their own showroom. So you had to leave the convention center. And I just didn't have there was so much to see at the convention center. But our friends over at Time to Play magazine had a video that they said, sure, show it on your show. So this is it's kids are going to love this. It's almost a little gross sounding, which will make kids even want to play it more. Okay, it's from Hasbro, and it's called Toilet Trouble.
Uh-oh. That's what I had on Thursday. No, I'm kidding.
Yes, yes.
Which flush will cause the gush? Find out in this fun and silly game from Hasbro. Hi, I'm Tammy with TTPM, and this is the Toilet Trouble game. It includes a game base, toilet tank with toilet paper roll spinner, toilet bowl with lid, and instructions. Two or more players, ages 4 and up, take turns spinning the toilet paper roll, flushing the toilet handle, and hoping they don't get sprayed with water. The number that turns up on the paper roll spinner dictates how many times each player must flush. With each flush, a player is either safe and hears a flushing sound, or a player gets sprayed with water. Thankfully, it's clean water that players pour in at the start of each game. Both funny and suspense-filled, this game will appeal to kids who enjoy good old-fashioned potty humor, and let's be honest, who doesn't? It's easy to play and sure to bring lots of laughs. Two AA batteries are included and some adult assembly is required, but we found it simple to do in just a couple minutes. For where to buy and current prices, find us at TTPM and subscribe to our YouTube channels for more reviews every day.
For a little bit of extra suspense, take the water out of your own toilet bowl. No, I'm just kidding.
Or for a potty game, use gin.
Yeah, exactly, right? Yeah, I'm sure.
There you go, yeah.
Any yeah, go. That's actually very, very funny. I love that. Toilet Trouble.
Toilet Trouble, and the sound effect is fun.
Right.
And you just get drenched a little bit so you're not overwhelmed. There's their commercial.
Here, let's play a little
spin
bit.
Spin the roll and see how many times you should flush. One. Sometimes you avoid the spray, and sometimes you won't. The last player to flush without getting sprayed wins.
Yes.
Face the flush with the Toilet Trouble game. Ages 4 and up, adult assembly required.
That looks really, really fun.
I think kids will really get a kick out of that.
I agree. I think an adult would really get a kick out of that.
Yeah, that's true.
Something about a toilet-shaped device that makes it just gross immediately.
Yes, absolutely.
I think that it may have been the Science Museum in San Francisco that had a water bowl. It had basically a drinking fountain that was toilet bowl shaped. That used a real toilet. They're like, even though this toilet has never been used, it's weird.
Yes!
You know, I forget what that was. The Imaginarium. I don't remember where it was, but
you mean like it was on a wall and people were supposed to drink from
it? It was a display. Yeah, I think the display was, if I remember correctly, it was years ago. It was a display about like how the human brain associates things, like how you associate things as cute. You know, that was one of the things. They had a station where you would make a cute thing, and why is that cute to the human brain? And so they had that toilet bowl set up that was like, this is disgusting, even though it's actually, you know, perfectly safe and sanitary. So yeah, exactly.
Very interesting.
Toilet Trouble from Hasbro.
Also available already on Amazon.
Amazon. And the price, let me grab
the price
that.
Is the same, about 20
yeah,
bucks.
Exactly. That's
1982.
That is toilet good. Trouble. I like that.
Water not included.
Supply your own water.
Right.
Just add water. Already,
on Amazon, it says, caution, to avoid injury, use only clean tap water.
Exactly. Exactly. Don't take Chad's advice on the Giz Wiz. It's a bad habit. Oh.
If people who have not been watching for years should know that Chad, as one of his gadgets, had a gadget called Life Straw, right?
Yes, yes, yes.
Life Straw for those trapped in the jungle who would want to drink out of a mangy, terrible pond. And Chad actually went down in Petaluma to, you went to the Turning Basin, right?
So here's the thing is, I didn't. This was, we got the Life Straw. The plan had been to grab water out of the toilet, which I was thinking, you know, that's already sanitary, right? It's just from the toilet. That's gross. And then they showed up on set and were like, hey, we have this water that we went and got from the Turning Basin.
Oh, my God.
You want to drink it? And it was on the spot. And I was like, okay, let's try it. We find out later that the Life Straw does not filter out heavy metals, viruses that are within a certain micron space.
Oh, my God. The Turning Basin is a place where there are some boats docked.
And it's
where boats come down the river and can't go any further and turn and go back up the river. So it's a filthy...
It's a really gross place.
I thought you had volunteered.
No, they you know, and they basically sprung it on me. You know, they told during the episode, they're like, hey, we did this thing. And I was like, okay, let's try it.
Oh, but then they immediately sent it to the doctor, didn't they?
Yeah, they did. They told me to go get checked up. Yeah, and I can't remember if he prescribed, he may have, I can't remember, he prescribed a antibiotic or not, just it wouldn't help for the viruses, but I can't remember what he did, or anyway, but yes, Leo paid for a doctor visit for me.
Oh, okay.
But yeah. With that, let's jump in to...
To Chad's...
Yo, yo,
crappy...
You might want it at Chad's... Crappy Corner. Get it.
Well, it is...
You've been doing some good stuff, too, so you'll tell us whether it's crappy or
we can determine by the end of this segment whether this is a crappy corner, a real crappy gadget, or possibly a not-so-crappy gadget.
Okay.
So this is a continuation of Security Month, and I went down to the security store, but this is a gadget that I have seen all over the place. I've seen it in Sky Mall. I've seen it online. I've seen it everywhere, and I just wanted to pick one up. This one happened to be on sale from the security store. This is a dummy security camera, and they come in all sorts of different types. And so you can kind of get one that might look different from every other one so that, would-be people who want to steal your stuff, would-be criminals, don't know what it is. So this is the security camera. Now, this one is solar-powered, and it comes with a red flashing light, which I like. So I assume that the solar panel will power that red flashing light. Let me grab it out of here.
You know what? I actually have two dummy cameras in my backyard.
Oh, fun.
But they are not solar powered, so this is very interesting.
Comes with a sticker, a CCTV you are on camera sticker. Comes with nickel metal hydride batteries, some rechargeable batteries. These are AAA, looks like. Yep, AAA. And some screws. So here is the actual... camera. Oh, here's the wire that doesn't do anything, obviously. So it looks like it has a ball joint right here, which you can loosen and tighten. So let's go ahead and tighten this up kind of at this downward facing angle, as maybe if it was on the side of something. Not exactly sure where the wire, I guess, would go in here. And then somewhere into the... Anyway, we'll deal with that later. First off, there is one wire just kind of hanging off to the side.
Oh, that's not good.
I think it's supposed to go into the solar panel.
Oh, no.
I think that this is supposed to go in here somewhere.
Oh.
Oops. Okay. Well, hey, it's strongly in the crappy corner category right now.
Yeah.
There is a open and on, so or off, so open. There we go. That's where you stick in your batteries. Let's see if maybe we can stick in the batteries. Maybe they have some charge and we can see the red blinking light, even if the solar panel is broken. So let's throw that one in. And that one in. Red blinking light. Show me. Oh. I thought I saw it. It may take a little while.
Yeah.
There it is.
Oh, there it is.
There it is.
Okay.
Okay, so that works. This may... That's always great. Okay, well, here's a random metal piece from inside of it. Not really sure what that does.
Oh, my gosh.
Okay, so, you know, the big thing to figure out would be, does this solar panel... This is why it was on sale, obviously. I don't know if the solar panel is going to recharge this battery at all.
Yeah, do you think if you just stick it in there and hope there's a piece of metal behind it?
Right.
That'll make contact with? Oh, my gosh.
Does not seem very... I don't know.
How much was this on sale for?
It was under $20. It says $27 on the side. But I believe that I got it for 19. Well, that my exposure is a little too hot there. But yeah, I think I got it for a little less. So, no, it does have some nice branding on the side. I like this.
Yeah, no, it's
it
nice.
It says day, night, CCD camera.
Yeah, the church and also it has all those dummy lights in the front.
Right, exactly. I mean, that it's hard to, even up close, that looks basically like a lens. You have all of the what would be the LEDs for
night vision
on there. I gotta say that it looks pretty good. I'm not exactly sure where the okay. So here's
I hope your neighbors aren't watching this episode.
Right, exactly. I'm telling you, it's real. Okay, so let's set this together a little bit. There we go. There's that. I found where this goes into. So plugs right up in there, and then you would take this and put it into the base, like so, and then of course this would snap on to the top as well. And there you go, you got one dummy camera all said and done.
I'd say it's really good looking.
I agree, pretty good looking. Possibly the one you get will have a solar panel that doesn't doesn't break immediately. So I did just doing some simple searches on Amazon. There's many, many, many to choose from.
Do they have a solar? I didn't see a solar power.
This one looks almost exactly like the one
I have.
And it has a solar panel on top.
Oh, it
for
does.
For half the price, for $10.99, and three customer reviews that seem to be 5 stars. So that is not a bad option right there.
No.
You know what I would wonder is maybe these LEDs at the front do put out a night vision. I doubt it, though. I highly doubt it.
You know what? Can you go... it looked like there was a 4-pack for $30?
For less?
Yeah.
Let's see.
Just on... there.
There we are. Oh, that was a sponsored post. Interesting. Let's see. Does it have... Oh, yeah. Look at that. Yeah, you hit that one right on the head. You
wow,
got a 4-pack.
So that
pack.
Brings him down to $10.50. Exactly. No,
less.
No, wow, it brings him down to
whatever I can, 30 divided head. By 4 is around
oh,
7.
My God,
around 7
terrible.
Each.
4 into 30. Six.
Yeah, 7.25, I believe. And let's see. So you can easily see that, and there's a whole bunch of different styles as well. Kind of have this two-lens style. This one seems to be a little bit more expensive. Oh, that's not a two-lens style. That is something else. I'm confused. what's going on that front there. Okay, you
the
got a little
flashlights
light.
And human center. Wow.
Interesting. Interesting. So you can see that on the security front, there's many, many different types of security cameras. The one that I always remember seeing nowadays kind of looks like fake. I don't even see it here on the page. The ones that I remember seeing in Sky Mall, things
it's just
like
a
that.
Dome, right?
Yeah, it was. Yeah, it was just either a dome or it was basically just a box with a lens. These ones now look so very sophisticated. This one is $5. That is one of those dome-looking security cameras. So very, very interesting stuff.
I think they work. I had somebody throwing cigarette butts out the window into my backyard. And so I bought two of those cameras, and I aimed them kind of up, and I faced one toward each building on either side of me, figuring no one in my building would be doing that. And now maybe I'll find one cigarette butt every 2 or 3 months. But nice. I used to get them almost daily, so someone thinks they're real.
Right, exactly. Or someone's trying to quit smoking. Either option. So there you go. Dummy camera. I got mine, at a physical store, but there's plenty to choose from Amazon. Make sure yours comes with a sticker, because this sticker is almost just as good as the camera itself. And you know what? Maybe I'll be using these AAA batteries here for a different project.
Well, you know what? Now that you have Charlie,
I remember
reading once tips from burglars, and one of them was, even if you don't have a dog,
put up a beware.
Leave an enormous bone and a giant water bowl by your back door.
That's good. In fact, find a friend that has a dog and let their dog chew on the bone for a day and then
take
the bone.
There you go. Because the guy said, if there are 15 houses in a row,
right.
even fake signs, they go, why would we even chance the
right.
person doesn't have a dog or doesn't have a camera? There are lots of houses that have nothing, so let's
right.
go there.
Right, exactly. I want to go to ADT and say, how much does it cost to just buy a sign? $5 for a sign? I would love that, please. Yeah, exactly. So that's great. Okay, so let's move on to Dick's Gadget Warehouse.
They're geeky and they're goofy. Together they are loopy. When gadgets pass away, he takes them out to play in Dick's Gadget Warehouse.
Foghorn!
And if you're a fan of the show, we use this segment for viewer videos, whether they're warehouse or anything of interest. And this is kind of interesting. This is from Chuck from SEAZ period. So I'm not sure if that is Arizona or AZ. Is that also Australia?
I don't know.
Anyway.
Yeah. He's from a place.
So he may or may not be getting a Mad Magazine and an Alfred E. Newman picture, but I'll explain that later. Hi, Dick and Chad. I saw a cool device on a previous episode of the Giz Wiz that I watch every week. You featured the message fan by Brookstone. I thought it was cool. I ordered one through Amazon. Here's a video to show you one way I used the message fan.
Oops.
A reminder to watch the Giz Wiz. So let's watch Chuck's use of the fan he learned about on the Giz Wiz.
Okay.
Hi, Dick and Chad. On a recent episode of the Giz Wiz, you featured a gadget that I thought was really cool. So I went on to Amazon, and I think I got the last one, and it came from Brookstone. And this is what I got.
Perfect.
Just a
That's
couple
the
days
one you
ago.
Have, right?
Yep, definitely.
This is the message fan, and I really like it. It really is cool. It's very easy to program different messages on here, different colors, and it works really, really great. Now, one of the cool features that I like to use on this is as a reminder. So here's how I use my Brookstone message fan as a reminder. All right, so this is one use of my message fan. After I downloaded the software onto my PC, and the software came with the fan, and it works really, really great. It didn't take that long to figure out how to program it. It does come with a booklet to give you some basic information on how to program in messages and upload them to the message fan. And I have the message fan now connected to a digital timer, as well as a audio source on the digital timer. So at the specific day and time that turns the timer on with the connected audio source and the message fan, this is the reminder that I get.
That is too cool! Wow!
Oh, it's time to turn on the Giz Wiz. Here we go.
That. What a good.
With Dickie D.
Wow.
That's really great.
After I've gotten the reminder on the message fan and got the TV on to watch the Giz Wiz, I can go and turn the message fan just to fan. It'll switch on the back there. So now it just helps blow some nice cool air. And since the Giz Wiz is one of the hottest shows on the net, having that fan and the reminder is great. So this message fan is one of my favorite newest gadgets, and I really like it. And it gives me a good reminder every week to tune in to watch the Giz Wiz. So thanks, Dick and Chad. Keep up the good work, and I'll be watching the next show.
That is too cool. How's that for an ego boost? Love
yeah.
it.
Yeah, wow, that's great.
That
Chuck,
is awesome.
Chuck, I'm not sure where you're from. Chuck from capital S-E space. AZ space. So Chuck, if you're
maybe, oh, you know what, that might be Southeast Arizona.
Oh, okay.
Maybe
Chuck, if you are if you're in the US or Canada, send us an email with your address and you'll get a copy of Mad Magazine. You'll get one of those 35-year-old Alfred E. Newman pictures. You get our thanks for having a great video, which is great fun. And I think we have one more video left. So if you want to join people like Chuck, who have a video shown on the show, make a little video, pretty much anything. Like, that was not an invention. It was not I bought a piece of crap. It was something he saw on the show and made even better. Anything you want. A 2 to 3 minute video. Put it on YouTube. As you upload it, if you want, click unlisted. And then only people with the link will be able to view the video. And send the link to us, mail at gizwiz.tv. And if we show it on the show, pretty much, we've pretty much shown them all. Occasionally, you know, just shoot it in landscape and just make sure we can see the product and hear you talking. That's basically all we're looking for. And again, we keep asking for new people. We do have some videos from people who send in, have been on the show a couple of times, but we're trying to get new people to contribute to the show. mail@gizwiz.tv. And Chuck, again, thanks. That was really great fun.
That was amazing. Thank you so much, Chuck. That is cool. With that, let's jump into the letter.
And our letter says, on a past episode, you talked about the fidget cube hitting the market. What you showed was not the fidget cube, but one of the numerous knockoffs. Chad was correct that China has been making cheap, crappy versions and flooding the market. Many are actually using fidget cube marketing materials, acting like they're being sold by ANSI Labs, who are the creator of the fidget cube. Even Woot fell for one of these and thought they were offering genuine fidget cubes, then had to offer a retraction and state they were not the genuine product. I backed them on Kickstarter as my son constantly fidgets, and we received our units as promised in the campaign. Several of his friends received the knockoff versions, and there is a very distinctive difference in the build quality. I just wanted to clear up the confusion and make sure viewers know the actual fidget cubes are not a buck or two. And if you purchase one for that price, you're not getting what you pay for. Thank you, Corey. Okay, Corey. So thank you for clearing that up.
Yeah,
that
is definitely.
That is amazing that it's kind of sad that
it is.
Someone can invent something and someone else can just absolutely knock it off. And then to use their advertising material.
Right. Just to go, okay, right click, save as. Okay, that's mine now. Yeah, exactly. Isn't that frustrating? I can't imagine. I can't imagine how frustrating that is. Also, to sink your own time, money, resources, dedication, and passion into a gadget, into a project, and then just have it totally, the carpet pulled out from under your feet. That stinks.
Well, fortunately, our show is so crappy, there's no way to knock it off.
Exactly.
Because there's no way to get a crappy copy.
There's no profit
of a crappy
to be made.
Show.
Yeah, exactly. Exactly.
That's right. If you want the real crap,
GizWiz.tv. Exactly. Exactly. That's great. Thank you so much, Corey, for letting us know and keeping us honest. And you know who else is honest? Our patrons over at patreon.com/gizwiz. Big thanks to you guys for supporting the show every episode.
I have to go look again. This is the 96th.
Oh my gosh.
Soon we will hit 2 years.
Wow, we're almost at 100 independent episodes. Wow.
Yeah.
Well, if you want to support the show, if you enjoy the show and want to give back, please do over at patreon.com/gizwiz. You don't have to give a lot. We're really not asking for a lot. If you gave 25 cents a show, that we do about 4 shows a month, $1 a month. Happy. We'd be great. That'd be fantastic. Big thanks to everyone who did take the plunge, who went through the process to become a patron over at patreon.com/gizwiz.
But Chad, I don't think I want to become a patron.
Well,
is there anything else I could do?
Some people, you know what? They don't want a reoccurring thing. They just want to give once. All you have to do is head on over to gizwiz.tv. There is a Patreon tab, but don't let that fool you. At the bottom, underneath the banner, there is a link to donate via PayPal. Oops, there it is right there. You can just give once. That's also fantastic. You guys are just super great for supporting the show. And big thank you to you guys. By the way, Marsworm has found, remember how I said, all I want is the ADT sign. The Here right. It Is on eBay.
Oh my gosh! Oh my god!
$21.
They want 20. It's a pick. It's one of those great big ones.
Right. It's one you put in the ground, and then it also comes with five actual stickers, because I think they put these stickers on your window.
Oh, that's a
Isn't that funny? Yeah. So, and you know, it's about half the cost of 1 month of ADT. You know, about a month is around $50. So
yeah,
that's pretty funny. That's great. Thank
that
you so much.
Very.
Get on over to gizwiz.biz. We kind of have two sites, gizwiz.biz and gizwiz.tv. Gizwiz.biz is run by Dickie D, and he writes up all of the show notes about all the gadgets. You can also find the What the Heck Is It game, where we try to guess the gadget once every other month. And this is the gadget that we're guessing right now. It's pretty obvious to me what this is. You've seen maybe the Furminator gets rid of fur. These little teeth in here get rid of fur. But this is if you have like a long animal, like a ferret, you can place one ferret here, one ferret there, and one ferret there, and Furminate them all three at the same time. It's such an amazing gadget. If you have a guess for what this gadget is, get a guess in over at gizwiz.biz. And if you want to catch the show live, we record about every... We record on Thursdays normally. We should be on that schedule next week. And if we... around 4:30 Pacific, 7:30 Eastern time. And if we're ever off a week, we like to put a banner at the top of our website, gizwiz.tv. That is the site that the show, only the show, lives on. And you can find past episodes, you can find links to subscribe so you will never miss an episode. And you can also join the chat room and join the live stream right there whenever we are live. That's at gizwiz.tv. That about wraps it up for this episode of the Giz Wiz. See you next week.
I'll be here.